the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL as you get a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Today we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Green Bay Packers. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. This place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. Today we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Green Bay Packers. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Coming off a career high in rushing yards last year, here's Aaron Jones. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. Gotta like that start. 14 yards to get him going. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
The Packers at 5-1 here in this early part of the season. They're in a real groove of late. Winners of 5 of their last 6.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Here we go. Ball on the 40 now. Here's 2nd and 9.
On the counter, here's Jones. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on 3rd and just 1 yard.
This defense for the Vikings, they were excellent in that win over the 49ers last week.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And a pretty athletic run right there as he's going to get this down inside the 40. 13 yards, first down Packers.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Now Love, he's got this complete to Jones.
Just a gain of a couple there. And it'll be 2nd down.
Hey, look at this defense for the Vikings.
They were excellent in that win over the 49ers last week.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, do you now decide that I can't throw the ball against this team and try and run it like crazy? Or do you challenge them? This is going to be fun.
On 2nd down, it's Jones. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7.
Red cycle. Needle blue.
Throwing. Love. A check down here to Jones. And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the first down marker. That's going to bring up 4th down, only a gain of 2 there. So off goes Love. On is Carlson for the Packer field goal. And this one is right down the middle. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. Even though they didn't find the end zone, they have to be pretty pleased with how they moved the ball on the ground, because we know that that was one of their big goals in this game.
And that really goes through the entire offense, because when you're running the ball effectively, just about everyone's involved. It's not just the guy carrying the football. It's everyone blocking for him, both inside and on the perimeter.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 26. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Oh, the first play of the game going to be intercepted. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. But no surprise to see that one, partner. The league's number one defense coming through with a huge pick six.
And it's plays like that one that have made them the most feared group to face this year. Offenses, they're trying to figure out how to work around them rather than work through them. Big-time impact playmakers scattered throughout the unit on every level, and they can change a game at a moment's notice.
So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Good starting field position for the Vikings as they have it first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Hunt will try going up the middle, and he'll manage to pick up about four in second down. You look at this Packers defense. They were terrific last week in the win over Denver.
And what I saw on film was nearly an unstoppable pass rush. They had 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries. So now do you just max protect on offense, keep everyone in and run, you know, 1 or 2 receiver routes to make sure your quarterback stays up? We'll soon find out.
Here's Cousins. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Cousins in step with Jefferson that time. First down, Vikings.
And the Vikings first down.
Handoff up the middle, Hunt. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Play action now. Cousins. A quick throw there is incomplete.
They kind of forced that one there, didn't they? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, and he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. To throw, Cousins. He'll get this one underneath to Hunt. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it 4th and inches.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a 4th down?
So they'll pass on what would have been a 49-yard field goal attempt, and they're going for it on 4th down. They'll try and run for it. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line.
Facing a fourth down, they come away with 18 yards and the first down conversion.
Fourth and inches in plus territory, that seemed like a prime spot to go for it.
It certainly did, and there's so many things that go into it. Are you too far away for a field goal, but not far away to punt it? Do you just feel like your offense is better? I just think in today's NFL, offense feels like it has to take care of the football, has to keep the ball, because scoring is up. You better maximize every possession. You trust your offense more than you trust your defense in today's league.
On first down, they go right back to Hunt. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota.
Kareem Hunt, his eighth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Vikings have got it back to within a score.
A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away.
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. 50 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
Now they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you've said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Six, mega, huge, yellow, strike it.
Love looking to throw it. Got his man, it's Bo Melton. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Second and a yard at the 41-yard line.
Ready.
From the 41, this is second and a yard.
Max.
Love going to give this one to Jones. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Packer first down.
And this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Ball on the 39. Here's second down and one.
38. On the ball.
They'll go again to Jones. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Ready up. Ball is red. Ready.
Play action this time with Love. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about four.
Going to get a break here for an injury. Aaron Jones is in some discomfort down on the field. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
On third down, Love. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
And he missed it. It's no good, and that will keep this a three-point game.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target, and knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Cousins now. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Now Charles dealing with a third and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again, and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
So now after the sack, Cousins and the Vikings come up here third and long. Back to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Now he's loose down the left sideline. Touchdown, Vikings. Jalen Reagor, his first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings have taken the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Ready, play.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And the way their last drive ended, boy, it was frustrating. They had a pretty good drive going. It was sustained, and then it stalled out, Charles, and they missed the field goal and got nothing out of it.
Is that insult to injury? Because they had such a sustained drive, as you noted. So you know for the head coach, it almost felt like a little bit of failure to send out the field goal unit and then to not even see the ball go through the post. What a bummer on that last drive for them. Got to pick themselves up from that one.
This offense so far on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Love from the gun. Out route, he finds his man, it's Jones. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Well, they'll use him a lot out of the backfield. He had 5 catches a week ago, and he makes another catch here for good yardage.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30.
Watch out now, 52.
Off the play fake, Love. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wide move there, looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
No sense risking anything there on 1st down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so he just put that in a spot where the only people who can make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
Love with a pass caught by Musgrave, the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. His 1st catch, good for 16 and a 1st.
So now,
1st and 10 at the 46-yard line. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this 1st half of action. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
Ready, couple set. Of 1st downs to kick off the drive. Here's 1st and 10 up at the 46. Cut. To throw now. Here's Love. A short throw to Musgrave. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45.
I don't care what sport you're playing. Everyone likes to build up a little momentum, don't they? And look at this. Back-to-back completions to the big target at tight end.
That one not as profitable as the other, but still a decent game.
Ready?
And he will slide to a stop. He does have the 1st down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
How about that there? No frills, no additives, right? Nothing crazy. Just find a way to pick up the 1st down. A nice run right there.
Ready.
Jordan Love, ready on 1st down here. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on 1st and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Now a 2nd down throw for Love here. Caught on the right side by Jones. They'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Ready?
Out of the shotgun, it's Love. Hauled in on the out route by Melton. The Vikings going to signal for the 1st of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number 1.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. It's
So an interesting decision at this stage of the game to go for it. Do you think maybe that missed field goal earlier had anything to do with it?
If it did, I'm really surprised, because usually one miss is not enough to alter your game plan. My only thought is maybe he got hurt, or maybe they just understand that it's not his day for some other reason we don't know right now. But in general situations, you run him back out there and let him have another chance.
To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now, because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. They follow up the gain at five by only getting one there on second down. For the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. First and 10, Cousins. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Again from the 20 after the incompletion. Here's second and 10.
Gun.
Addison will go in motion left. Second down, Cousins again. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play, because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Well, they need two. Here's third down. Looks again for T.J. Hockenson, and he's got him again. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and that'll bring up fourth down.
If this were baseball, we'd call this small ball. Instead of pushing it downfield, they throw a short pass trying to pick up the first down, but the defense rallies to the football and stops him short, bringing up a fourth down.
In their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. He needed less than a foot. He didn't get a whole lot more than that, but he did get the first down.
Well, he and his offensive line created enough push where if he was able to just fall forward as he was able to there, that would pick up the first down. As you noted, didn't need a whole lot, didn't get much more than that.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They run again with Hunt, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Big Kenny Clark that time pushing upfield to make the tackle for loss.
I think we got to give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Now Cousins. And his throw is incomplete.
Everything looked right on that play except the conclusion. He dropped it. An in route going into a little bit of traffic. Maybe in the back of his mind, he was wondering where the hit was going to come from.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Throwing, Cousins. And that will be incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
And here's Ryan right now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. This is fielded at the 7. A very good kick there, but 15 yards on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10.
Here we go.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. On play action, love to throw. It throws it on the move, but can't connect as that falls incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Love. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. Down to the 10. Touchdown, Packers! Aaron Jones, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Packers have retaken a third quarter lead. So on 3rd and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. 1st and 10. Shreds him with a stiff arm. A big play there for Minnesota. 44 yards.
And this is how you answer a touchdown at the other end. You come out throwing to start your own drive. And not just throwing, but pushing it down the field. And they come up with a big play as they try to answer back with a score of their own.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's 1st and 10, just outside the 30. They'll run with Hunt. And a hard working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. 54 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
So they go pass, now they go run, and two plays resulting in really nice pickups.
Certainly sounds like a 50-50 deal, doesn't it? Sounds like great balance. Well, you know what all those coaches have told us over the years, Brandon, that balance is? It means doing what you want to when you want to. That play call is working very well for them right now.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. But now he appears to be in some pain. The medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12.
Quaker on the hop.
Play fake. Cousins. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Quay Walker came through to make the sack.
The passing game's been struggling a bit today, and that was the latest example. Haven't been getting much yardage out of it, and now on his back after the last play, he faces third and long.
Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long. They're going to look to throw into the hands of the rookie Jordan Addison. And he's going to come up well short as they rally up to stop him at about the 16. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a fourth and long.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And this one is right through. And they have regained the lead. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points. It will give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around.
Wait, wait.
Love now on second down. That's caught by the rookie, Jaden Reed. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. First target, first catch, and a first down.
First down 10 at the 35-yard line.
Working out of the gun, Love. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Let's go.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. No gain on the play there. Second down.
When you're trying to create space for your running back, the first thought is how physical is the offensive line. Sometimes it's just positioning. On that play, it didn't matter about positioning or being physical. The defensive front, they out-leveraged them and won the battle.
Down.
Here's second and 10.
Ready?
Again, it's Jones. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. Play action this time with Love. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 30. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line. 98 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Right.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Ready?
From the shotgun to give to Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
On the set.
So from the 17, here's second and 7.
Yellow. Cut, cut.
Love, they go play action now. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
Blue strike. Drill green.
On third down, Love. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to 3. And his kick is indeed good, and they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ballgame. Rashawn Gary that time through the line and getting the tackle for loss.
Yes, indeed. That play there, that reminds me of some of the guys that I played with to have that suddenness, able to get into the backfield almost about the time the ball snapped and make a play. How about that tackle for a loss?
Absolutely. He did a lot of that last week when he was named the NFC Defensive Player of the Week. One of the guys on the team was saying, yeah, we called him the disruptor. And that's carrying forward again.
Makes sense, doesn't it?
This is 3rd and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. The slot man in motion right. Cousins on 3rd and 2. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Here's a handoff to Hunt running left. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
Play action now. Cousins. Blitz coming and down he goes. Rashawn Gary able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Gary's point in his 2021 was no fluke. Had six sacks in nine games before a torn ACL ended his 2022 early. Looks like he's back in full form with plays like that.
This crowd turning up the decibel level. It's third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Here we go. This is fourth down. Desperation time. Cousins on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Vikings unable to convert here on fourth. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there.
Opposite, green.
We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. Inside of 2 minutes remaining in a two-point ball game. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line.
Ready.
Second and five.
Black shot. Red cycle. Ready.
Now Love. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he's as fine with that incompletion as a quarterback can be, in all honesty. He avoided his first sack of the game, and he did have a chance of connecting for yardage, just unable to on that throw.
This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. An inside give to Jones, and he won't get close. Only a yard, fourth and three. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
A short throw to Musgrave, and he is going to have the Packers first down by a couple of yards as they get five there on fourth and three. That one a backbreaker as they wind up converting there on fourth. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. 5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 1:06 left to go in the game. Good gain there on first down. That keeps them in a running situation probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. Here's a second and five.
Check white. Yellow. Lonnie. Hut.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw, out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
Ready?
On third down, here's Jones. And he's going to be stopped well short of what he needed as the tackle is made at the 18-yard line.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Anders Carlson on for the field goal. A 35-yard attempt.
And his kick is good. And that will push the lead up to five. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. Special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Here's first and 10. They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
He's brought down at the 20-yard line.
Well, it took us until the final play chart to officially decide a winner, although on that last play they were so backed up it would have taken a miracle and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
So for Green Bay, they remain one of the hottest teams out there as the win moves them to 6-1. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, the struggles intensify as they drop to 2-6 now on the year. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head to Atlanta for a matchup.
Since the basement making items over seasons with the man in black is teasing with my patterns. Pretty girl, she think I'm handsome. Just coasting through these mansions. I'm not bossing, I'm advancing. I'm a keep it moving, trying to be on before be low. Wanna be intimate with soul, explore this war before I go. And after some hours in my face, way now it's like work for 10K or cause it is pen gaming. Been insane in the membrane since them days where we raved for 3 days and 4 nights and took them red eye flights. Fought straight off the plane and through the back door of the place. Then I stepped on stage, they were like, see the crowd going at, they were like, so I stepped on stage, they were like, ooh, yeah. Raised by some Zulu lions, taught to seek dangers, brave and defiance, boy, the Lord was doing favors, blazed through the fire, yeah, we had a few, lost a few wages, still coming rampant, misbehaving, misbehaviors, still coming anti-up, rebelling with my ravers, still don't give a f*** about who be the latest, can't be locked up in them cages, start living up to what the f*** you think of days,
but hey, what about it?
So I stepped on stage, they were like, see the crowd going.
It's like, I've been smooth for so long, I'm trying to get rough. Buffing my nails, dog, I'm trying to get buff. Shaping my beard up, I'm liking the scruff. The hills, cause I'm living my life in the cut. Can't imagine that I'm gonna meet my wife in the club. We gon' see though, I feel like she more of a CEO. Or maybe she doing volunteer work in Rio. It's not like I need her, but I would love to meet her. Another day, another dollar, another phone with another feature. I don't play goalie, but I'm my brother's keeper. Surrounded by family, I'm not with other people. They say I got my pop's demeanor and mother's features. The garden's still private as ever. The gang thriving together. Your boy's striving to be the most dominant ever. The hardest white boy since the one who rapped about vomiting sweaters and holding comments. Cause I promise you I'm honestly better than whoever came to your head right then. They ain't cut from the same thread like him. They don't study doing work to get ahead like him. They don't toss and turn in the bed like him. Cause they don't love it. 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 I've been laid back so long, I'm trying to get turned. Searching my name, dog, that's how you get hurt. Being likable, I'm trying to be unbreakable. I just realized that this whole game is takeable if I want it. And I do, yes, I want it. I don't care how you feel about it. I do what I want to. I used to look up to the people that I'm moving in front of. It's not that crazy anymore. My city used to a come up. Bryce and Jack G. James is up next. The rest is up to me. These lames is upset. My peers get upstaged. The fans are obsessed. My city is upcoming. These people are oppressed. And I'm going to change things. I'm up at Carmichael's.